Hi, I'm Byron Udell, founder and CEO of AccuQuote. Since 1986, AccuQuote has helped millions of people save a fortune on their life insurance. One of the most common things that people want to know about when they're thinking about life insurance is whether the coverage that's offered to them through their job at work is better or less expensive than coverage they can buy in the open market on an individual basis. Today, I'm going to give you all the information you need to know the answer to that question, and it may surprise you. First, let me say that any coverage you get at work for free is, of course, free, and how can anyone argue with free? So is there any downside to free coverage? I had to think about this one, and, well, I suppose it depends on how you look at it. It could be said that a downside of free coverage at work is that a lot of folks think that since they have life insurance as part of their benefits package at work, that they simply have it and don't need to do anything further. The fact is that most of the time, the coverage you get at work for free is merely a token amount of coverage. Life insurance is not a yes-no proposition. In order for it to do what it's designed to do, it needs to be an amount of coverage that's reasonably going to replace your economic value to your family when you die. Most of the time, the free stuff at work is just something like $10,000 to $25,000 or maybe one or two times your salary, which is not nearly enough, especially if you have anyone relying on you financially. So if you were thinking that you're all set because you have free coverage at work, then that is a downside because it may cause you not to pursue the right amount of coverage, which could lead you to becoming underinsured, which could cause financial harm to your family if you die without the right amount of coverage. Now, I'm not saying don't take it. You'd be a fool not to take free coverage, but it would also be foolish not to solve for the gap between what they give you free and what it would take to really replace your income. The second downside to free coverage at work is that even if it is enough, again, which it rarely is that when you leave your job, whether voluntary or you get fired, riffed, downsized, let go, or whatever you want to call it, you lose the coverage. It's not portable. Your next job may not have the same benefits, not to mention the possibility that it may be a while before you land a new job. Meanwhile, you're not covered at all. So now that we've addressed the free coverage, which is nice to have, the rest of this video will address the differences between the additional group life coverage you can either sign up for at work and that you pay for through payroll deductions, or perhaps you're considering some group coverage that may be available through one or more association group plans that you get offers from in the mail. One common assumption about group life insurance is that since it's a group plan offered to me at work as an employee benefit, or through my association, there must be some sort of volume discount, right? Most people think that means it must be less expensive than individually purchased coverage available in the open marketplace. I want to make sure there's no ambiguity on this point. Nothing could be further from the truth. The fact is, that assumption is simply not accurate. In fact, group term life plans are, with rare exception, almost always more expensive than individual, fully underwritten life insurance policies. And there's a simple reason why. Group plans do less underwriting. They ask fewer questions, and they put you through less of a process to qualify. Sometimes there's even a guarantee that you can buy up to several times your salary with no medical questions at all. Without the ability to screen out the bad risks, and since everyone gets the same rate regardless of their health, those bad risks routinely come aboard these plans and end up causing the rates to be needlessly high for folks that could have otherwise qualified for a much lower healthy rate outside the group. In the insurance business, that's called anti-selection. All you need to know is that it makes rates higher. Of course, if you're one of those folks with serious medical issues that would make it impossible or prohibitively expensive to get an individually underwritten plan, voluntary group plans at work could be a great way for you to get the coverage you couldn't otherwise get anywhere else. But if you're relatively healthy, it's almost never your best choice. Group term life plans are almost always priced in five-year age bands. For example, there's a cost per thousand for ages 35 to 39, another higher price for ages 40 to 44, 45 to 49, and so on. If you're not sure about that, look at your plan and you'll see. At each successive age band, the price goes up more than the last. So as you get older, your price jumps each time you cross over into another age band. And with group plans, prices even within those age bands are not guaranteed year to year. In contrast, most individual term plans that people buy nowadays have guaranteed premiums for 10, 15, 20, and even 30 years. Group plans just don't do this. Their premiums will rise as you get older. And once you reach age 50, group plans really start getting prohibitively expensive. It gets even worse at 55, crazier at age 60 and 65 before they cancel you and throw you on the street at age 65 or 70. And that's on purpose, right before you're actually more likely to die and make a claim. Let's take a look at typical group pricing. As you can see, at age 45 to 49, the price for, say, $250,000 of death benefit on the group plan is $450 a year. And at age 50, that price will go to $690. At age 55, it goes to $1,290. And at age 60, all the way up to $1,980. If our healthy 45-year-old would have bought a commonly available 20-year guaranteed level term, his price would be guaranteed at only $330 a year for the entire 20-year period. Compared to the group pricing, the savings begin immediately, and over the 20-year period, they just get bigger. In cases like these, which we see every day, the total savings on just $250,000 of coverage totals over $15,000. Obviously, the results can vary depending on your age, health, and the exact pricing on your group plan, but it's really easy to find out what the savings are. Group plans also have a finite end, usually at age 65, possibly at age 70, and it's designed that way on purpose so the policy ends before you end. At that point, you may or may not have any option to continue life insurance at any price. We have found that most folks that have owned life insurance most of their lives are not all that excited about getting rid of it at age 65 or 70. Perhaps they still have a spouse and want to make sure that he or she has enough to live on because they're not yet independently wealthy. Maybe they were hoping to leave some money to cover final expenses or a little something extra to help their kids pay off college loans or perhaps a down payment on a house or maybe to help them start a business. Now, lastly, let's talk about the convertibility of group term plans. While most individual term life policies are fully convertible to permanent insurance, no matter how much your health may have deteriorated, group plans, on the other hand, may or may not be convertible. And often when they are, the products that they allow you to convert into are ridiculously expensive. Having convertibility may not seem important to you now while you're healthy, but as we get older, as springs start to pop loose and as we begin leaking oil here and there, the ability to walk in the door of a life insurance company with a convertible term policy is a ticket to be able to buy a permanent life insurance policy without having to answer a single health question. And that can be the difference between whether you end up dying with life insurance or without life insurance. Whether you realize it or not, good convertibility is a big deal. So, to summarize, group term life is more expensive to begin with, especially at ages 45 and up. The price, which isn't even guaranteed year to year, definitely does go up every 5 years, rather than remaining level for 10 to 30 years, or even forever, like individual life insurance policies. Group life, you buy at work, isn't portable, so that when you separate from your job, you lose it. It's also generally not available in face amounts large enough to meet most people's needs. It typically ends at retirement, while individual plans can be kept much longer. And lastly, its convertibility is either non-existent or abysmal compared to individual life insurance plans. So you might ask, why would anyone pay more, have no certainty or guarantees about future costs, take the risk of losing their coverage when they leave their job, and possibly be forced out at retirement when you may want to keep the coverage? Well, group coverage is easy and it's convenient. That's about it. Everything else about it, in my mind, is a negative. If you want to see how much you'd actually save using an individual plan versus your group life insurance at work or through any association, just give us a call at the number on your screen and we'll be happy to show you the pricing so that you can see the difference. In most cases, the savings on individual life insurance policies versus group life insurance, especially over time, can be dramatic. Thanks for listening.